making headlines. Turks and Caicos Islands election date is set. Deadline to register as independent candidate fast approaching. And new chief and deputy of medical services appointed. Hey there, Turks and Caicos, I'm Latoya, walking with your Monday, January 11th, 2021 edition of Newswatch. Let's get right into the news. After months of anticipation, a date has been set for the next general elections. Honorable Charlene Cartwright Robinson delivered the highly anticipated announcement during a momentous podium rally in the nation's capital over the weekend. Take a look at Monday's leading story.
I am proud to announce that the general election will be held here in the Turks and Caicos Islands on February the 19th, 2021.
And there you have it. On February 19th, 2021, voters will head to the polls to vote in the next government of the Turks and Caicos Islands. The premier said on Saturday night that she saw it fit to return to the nation's capital in order to deliver the momentous announcement.
I return to this island with pride, but with humility. And I come back here with scars, bloodied by the many battles I have fought for you. Yep. And I have returned to say that I am ready for the next fight. For as much as we have done, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Nomination day is January 29th. The People's Democratic Movement announced last week that they would be holding a virtual event with important information that no one, regardless of their political preferences, would want to miss. And this got the streets buzzing that just maybe it would be the announcement of Election Day 2021. And so it was.
Ladies and gentlemen, we shall move forward with faith and with hope. We shall make history again together. On February 19th, the fight continues to lift our people up. And so we say, forward ever and backward never.
Voters and politicians around the country waited in high anticipation for the announcement of the next general election since late last year. And the anticipation only heightened following the dissolution of the House in late December. Just the day before Saturday's announcement, Leader of the Opposition, Honorable Washington Mizik, issued a letter to the governor calling for his intervention as the days were being counted to the 35th day following the dissolution of the House without notice of a date for the next general election. Well, February 19th, 2021, it is.
We'll take a quick commercial break now. When we return, deadline to register as independent candidate fast approaching. More News Watch when we come back.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providence Jollies, Mides Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. The Integrity Commission of the Turks and Caicos Islands is notifying the general public that the deadline to register as an independent candidate in the upcoming election ends this week. With the general election proclamation having been made on Saturday, the 9th of January, under Section 69(6) of the Political Activities Ordinance, the deadline for persons interested in being registered as independent candidates in the upcoming general election is Friday, January 15, 2021. The Integrity Commission says that all interested persons may visit the offices of the Integrity Commission and Franklin Mizik's building in Grand Turk or Providenciales office at Unit 204 Cobbett House at the Graceway Plaza Leeward Highway to pick up an application packet. Persons are, however, strongly advised to visit the website of the Commission at www.integritycommission.tc, where under the Political Activities Heda, there is a form for the registration as an independent candidate, Form 1A. The application form, Form 1A, has to be completed as specified under Section 69(1) of the Political Activities Ordinance, which is also available on the Commission's website. All interested persons are also advised that they should familiarize themselves with Section 69, 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8 of the Political Activities Ordinance prior to completing the form. Persons applying to be registered should also familiarize themselves with the Constitution of the Turks and Caicos Islands, in particular Part 4, Section 42 to 76, and specifically Sections 49 and 50. A link to the Constitution is available on the Commission's website under the History of the Commission. All persons desiring to register as an independent candidate must also submit their constitutional Section 491F notice of any contracts they may have with the Turks and Caicos Islands government to the Commission when they are submitting their application for registration. It was also pointed out that the Commission has been carrying out virtual engagements with interested persons and will continue to do so during the upcoming weeks. It is therefore very important that you contact the Commission to be included in the engagement sessions. Interested persons can contact the Commission via email at deputydirector@integritycommissions.tc, publicedu@integritycommissions.tc, or via telephone 338-3335-338-3340. InterHealth Canada Turks and Caicos Islands Hospital has announced the appointment of a Chief and Deputy of Medical Services. Take a look. Effective January 1st, InterHealth Canada Turks and Caicos Islands Hospital announced the appointment of Dr. Dawn Perry Ewing as Chief and Dr. Sinati Amadi as Deputy Chief of Medical Services. Commenting on the appointments, Chief Executive Officer Dr. Denise Bradway Tennant stated, quote, Dr. Perry Ewing is one of the longest-serving members of the hospital medical team. She has a wide range of experience due to her years of service within the public and private sector, operating at executive roles and driving strategic health system developments. Dr. Perry Ewing has led her team in several successful accreditation projects and quality improvement initiatives. Dr. Sani Amadi is passionate about people and quality improvement. He is dedicated, hardworking, and an experienced specialist physician with a wealth of knowledge. He has been the lead for our medical reconciliation initiative that has won his team the Diamond Challenge, end quote. She continued, quote, both candidates were selected following a competitive interview process involving several of our talented medical professionals. They both possess a wealth of experience, and I am confident that their input at the senior management level will add value to our operations and the wider community. End quote. In response to her appointment, newly appointed Chief of Medical Services, Dr. Dawn Perry Ewing stated, quote, as a member of the healthcare provider team of the TCI Hospital, I am committed to the continued mission and vision of our organization and delivering quality healthcare to the people of the Turks and Caicos Islands. It is my hope that the new physician leadership of the institution in these most challenging times will provide our community, our staff, and our stakeholder partners in healthcare with the support and fortitude that is so greatly required as we face 2021. End quote. Deputy Chief of Medical Services Dr. Sani Amadi stated, quote, I am humbled and elated to accept the call to serve as the Deputy Chief of Medical Services. I am excited about the possibilities that are ahead and the ability to contribute to the upcoming teaching hospital program and train new local junior doctors. I will strive not only to be a success within my role, but also to be a value to the wider community. Thank you to the entire team for your continuous support. And a quick break now, but when we return, your weather forecast for Tuesday. More News Watch when we come back.
In order to auto-scan your PTV set-top box, you need to follow these basic steps. Turn on your television and set-top box. Press menu on the remote control. Choose installation and press OK. Enter password, press 0000. Choose auto search and press OK. Go down to start search and press OK. Choose yes and press OK. The box will start searching for channels until process bar reach 100%. Click on exit and data will be saved. Click on exit again to continue enjoying the PTV experience. Thank you for supporting the PTV network.
Sunny skies across the Turks and Caicos Islands. Here's the weather forecast for January 12, 2021. Starting off in Grand Turk on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 79, low 74, winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. South Caicos on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 79, low 74, winds south-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. North and Middle Caicos on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 79, low 72, winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Parrot and Pine Key on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 79, low 73, winds south-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And finally, on Providenciales on Tuesday, mostly sunny skies, high 79, low 73, winds south-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Time now for your sunrise and sunset. Sunrise at 6:31 a.m., sunset at 5:26 p.m. For your high tides and low tides, high tides 6:43 a.m., 7:09 p.m., low tides 12:15 a.m., 1:11 p.m. And that's it for your weather forecast. We'll be right back with more Newswatch.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providenciales, Mides Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. COVID-19 cases are on a continuous rise, according to the country's dashboard. And officials say social gatherings and workplace clusters are to be blamed. Here's more.
The last time the TCI saw a steady rise in cases, much like what we've been witnessing these last few weeks, was back in August 2020, when the country would hit almost 400 active cases. It seems there is a struggle with preventing cluster transmission throughout the islands, specifically on the islands of Providenciales and Grand Turk. Newswatch also learns that an additional 8 hospital employees have recently tested positive for the virus, bringing numbers to 10, with 7 at the Cogburn Medical Center and 3 at Cheshire Hall. The country hits 175 cases for the second time within 6 months on January 9th, when health officials recorded a whopping 29 new cases in just 24 hours, with 89 test results pending and 442 persons in quarantine at the moment. Officials said last week that this second major spike in cases is due largely to social gatherings and workplace clusters.
The evidence indicate that the majority of these new cases were linked to social gatherings and workplace transmissions, with unsafe social gatherings being the top source of transmission.
Since the spike, Ministry of Health and Ministry of Education officials have made the decision to postpone the reintegration of face-to-face learning for students until the end of January, in hopes that cases by then would have begun to decline. It seems that the implementation of stricter measures would be last resort for local lawmakers, perhaps especially since the arrival of the Pfizer and BioNTech vaccine on January 7th. Health practitioners are set to begin inoculations as early as today, Monday, January 11th.
That's all the news we have for you today. Of course, it's a pleasure to have you join us every weekday on Channel 8. Miss today's newscast or want to view more content, please feel free to log on to www.ptvatci.com, where you can access all archives. Remember to wash your hands and social distance at all times. I'm Latoya Walken. I'll see you next time.